Welcome. In this video, we are going to have Drupal create two database tables for us. This is helpful because we can begin to leverage the database API in coming videos. The Rsvp list module requires two database tables for its functionality. The Rsvp list table records the details of the RSVPs, and the Rsvp list underscore enabled table keeps track of which specific nodes have been indicated by site administrators to have the RSVP functionality enabled. Note that the established generic data types within a Drupal database are char, varchar, text, blob, int, float, numeric, and serial. This video does not cover the differences between them. Please do your own research if you need to. To overview each RSVP list database table, the RSVP list table has five columns: ID, UID, NID, mail, and created. The data types respectively for each are serial, integer, integer, varchar, and integer. The primary key for the RSVP list table is ID, and its indexes are node and node underscore user. The RSVP list underscore enable table has one column called NID, which is also its primary key. Before we jump into coding, I want to introduce the Schema API, a small and useful API that Drupal offers. Similar to the Form API, the Schema API allows modules to declare their database tables through a structured array. Starting with Drupal 9, the Schema API itself is becoming focused in scope because most of its original functionality has either been merged into the database abstraction layer or some of its original features have been removed. But historically, the Drupal Schema API provided functions for creating, dropping, and changing database tables, columns, keys, and indexes with code. Your module's .install file is responsible for containing functions which deal with module installation, updates, and uninstallation. At this time, hook schema is one of the most useful features of the Schema API, and it must be placed in the .install file. Similar to how Drupal's Form API defines a form with a multidimensional array, a database schema is also defined with a multidimensional array. It's responsible for declaring one or more tables and their associated keys and indexes. Take note that database tables declared by hook schema are automatically created when the module is installed. And be mindful that those tables are removed when the module is uninstalled. So if your module handles important data, think twice before uninstalling it, especially if other modules or external processes depend on that module's data. All right, this is enough theory for now. Let's get to instructing Drupal to create those two tables mentioned earlier, RSVP list and RSVP list underscore enabled. Have your code editor ready to go with the RSVP list module loaded. Fantastic. Let's begin by creating the install file where the hook schema function must be placed. Keep in mind to always pause the video when you need to. In your code editor, in the base directory of the RSVP list module, create a new file called rsvplist.install. rsvplist.install. Super! Since this is a PHP file, be sure to include the full PHP tag and the supporting @file doc block. Now, let's begin the schema hook. Type. Always remember that closing curly bracket. Ultimately, this function returns an array containing the details of the schema of the tables to create. So let's declare a variable with those specifics so we can return it. Since this is an array, be sure to include the closing bracket and semicolon. This array variable is responsible for creating a database table called rsvplist. Any array keys we enter within this schema rsvplist variable are particulars which apply directly to the rsvplist database table. Continuing on, the next step is to enter the key of description. Be sure to include the trailing comma. If you noticed that this text is not wrapped in the T translation function, superb attention to detail. The reason this text is not wrapped in Drupal's translation function is because this text description gets written once directly to the database. It is not text dynamically displayed by Drupal. The next key to enter is going to be the fields key, which is also a multi-dimensional array containing the specifics for each database field, which is to say the specifics for each column in this RSVP list table. As always, be sure to type the closing square bracket. This time though, do not end with a semicolon. Instead, end this embedded fields array with a comma as per Drupal coding standards. Great work entering this code so far. Your keyboard is so happy. For our first database column, enter this code. Be mindful of all single quotes and pay attention to the trailing comma after the closing square bracket. The name of this column is ID, and it is of the type serial, which means it will automatically increment after every record insert. Other properties of this column are that it has a size of small, is unsigned, and it cannot be null. Size small, unsigned means it is capable of holding 65,535 records. If you expect more RSVPs than that, you can change the size to a large one. Acceptable sizes are indicated. The second database column is UID, which will hold the user ID of the user which places the RSVP. It is of type integer and can be described with the following code. Notice that the default of this UID field is 0, and it is typed without quotes. If it were wrapped in quotes, it would be the character 0, which doesn't make sense since this is an integer field. The third column is NID, indicating the ID of the node for which the RSVP applies to. As an integer type, it is similar to the UID column, but here we indicate that it is unsigned. Also, notice that with both the NID and UID columns, we do not indicate a size like we did with the serialized ID column. Since no size is indicated for the UID and NID columns, they will be created to the default integer size as configured by the database. The fourth column is mail, to contain the email address entered by the user when RSVPing. This is of type varchar with a length of 64, meaning it can hold 64 characters. As an important note with varchar types in general, make sure you are aware of the effects of a multi-byte character set. Super! So the final column in the RSVP list database table is created. This is also a type of integer and is intended to hold the Unix timestamp of when the RSVP was made. Great work on completing the columns for the RSVP list table. The next array key to set for this table is the primary key. Indicate that the ID column should be the primary key with this code. Notice the column name is encapsulated in an array. Woohoo! We're almost finished defining this RSVP list table. The final step is to indicate any indexes on the table. We will have an index based on NID and an index based on NID and UID. The code is, again, notice that each index is encapsulated in an array. Fantastic. This completes the definition for the RSVP list table. Great job. The following table, RSVP list underscore enabled, is less complex. It only has one column. Let's begin the definition with this code. As we did with the RSVP list table, be sure to include the closing bracket and semicolon. Enter the description of this table like so. As before, this text is not wrapped in the T translation function of Drupal. Next, begin to declare any table columns like so. Again, because the fields array is embedded within the schema RSVP list underscore enabled array, be sure to end the fields array with a comma per Drupal coding standards. The only column is NID, just like the NID column of the RSVP list table. The only difference between them is the description. The concluding array key for this table is primary key, which will use the NID column. Enter it like so. Incredible! This concludes the schema array variable defining the two tables to be created by Drupal upon module installation. But let's not get too excited and forget perhaps the most important step of hook schema. We need to return the schemas we have defined. The final line is... Yes! Be sure to double check your code, paying special attention to all single quotes and to all commas. When you are ready, save the file and head on over to your site. Now that we are back at your site, even though we did a code change, in this case, we do not need to flush the cache because hook schema is only ever executed upon module install or module uninstall. This means what you think it means. Before we uninstall RSVP list, I want to investigate the database of my site so we can see the before and after results. This database investigation demonstration is optional. In fact, I almost encourage you not to do this because I do not want you to develop confidence in bad habits to perform on a production site. But because we are on a development instance and because we have curious minds, let's dive into exploring the database. It is likely that your local development environment offers you a way to inspect the database. Obviously, I cannot cover every possible scenario, so I encourage you to investigate the documentation of whatever solution you are using if you wish to follow along. I have my local database open in this tab here, exploring using Phpmyadmin. With regards to the two tables we just defined, there is nothing too exciting to see here. There are no tables called RSVP list or RSVP list underscore enabled. This is expected because, as we learned, hook schema is only ever executed on install or uninstall. So, heading over to my site, I will uninstall the RSVP list module by visiting extend, then clicking uninstall. Then, I'll find RSVP list to checkmark it, and then to do the needful of uninstalling. Doo-ba-doo, oh yeah! Let's now reinstall the RSVP list module. Head to the module listings, find RSVP list, checkmark it, install, boom! RSVP list has been installed. I'll now head back over to Phpmyadmin to see if anything has changed. After refreshing the page, I can see the RSVP list and RSVP list enabled tables are now present. Yabba-doo! If we investigate the structure of each table, we see that they reflect the specifics of what we defined in the .install file using hook schema. In examining the RSVP list table, we see that there are indeed five columns: ID, UID, NID, male, and created. Each as the types we defined. Notice that the primary key is ID, and there are indexes of node and node underscore user. Oh, this is fabulous! If we check the RSVP list enabled table, we can see that there are similar results. There is one column of NID and it is the primary key. Great work! If you'd like to see more information on the field or column types, be sure to check out the resources provided. Happy learning!